Hi everybody, myself Dr. K.S. Raghuram. I am dealing the course of Automobile Engineering. In the Automobile Engineering course, lecture 2, the topic is Transmission System. In the Transmission System, now I am going to deliver the topic on clutches, principle of clutches, and types of clutches. Three topics I want to explain. And syllabus of the second unit is like this. Transmission System is the main topic. In the main topic, clutches, principle of clutches, types of clutches. The types of clutches are cone clutch, single plate clutch, multi plate clutch, magnetic clutch, centrifugal clutch, fluid flywheel, gearboxes, types of gearboxes, sliding mesh gearbox, constant mesh gearbox, synchro mesh gearbox, epicyclic gearbox, power drive torque converter, propeller shaft, types of propeller shafts, Hotchkiss drive, torque tube drive, universal joint, differential, rear axles, types of rear axles, types of wheels and tires. Now clutches, its principle of clutch and type. The outcome of the unit 2 is like this. The student can understand the concept of engaging and disengaging of the clutch. What is meant by engaging of the clutch? What happens when the clutch is engaged? And disengagement of the clutch, what happens when the clutch is disengaged? So this is the outcome of the topic. And importance of friction. So why friction is necessary for a clutch assembly? Types of clutches used in various automobiles. And now, in the transmission system, what is the necessity of the clutch, right? So it is, as I told you earlier, it is used to engage or disengage the engine's power to the transmission. As you know, as already discussed earlier, in first unit, this is the engine. That is the transmission going on in a four-wheeler, right? The power developed by the engine is to be transferred to the gearbox by means of the clutch. Right, so and again, whenever the movement of the vehicle is not required, every time we should not stop the engine, but we have to stop the vehicle. Right, here engine and vehicle. Say for example, you are stopping the automobile or car at the signal point. Right, as in some ads, they are showing that when the vehicle has to stop for a few minutes also, engine has to be stopped. That is wrong concept, right? We have to stop the engine if and only if the vehicle has to stop for more than 5 minutes. If it has to stop for less than 5 minutes, the engine should not run. The engine has to run idly. That means without movement of the vehicle, the engine has to run. So that is given by this clutch. What the clutch does is, whenever required, it catches up the engine's power and transmits to the gearbox. Whenever not required, it disengages the engine's power to the transmission. That is the main operation of the clutch. Right? So it enables the rotary motion of one shaft to be transmitted to the rotary motion of the second shaft. So, what are the requirements of the clutch? So, the clutch has to require the torque. That is, the torque transmission is the first requirement. Gradual engagement, because the engine's power is to be transmitted to the rear wheels gradually, not all of a sudden. If the power is given all of a sudden, what happens is there will be a jerky motion to the vehicle, which is not good to the passengers or as well as the load of the automobile. That's why the clutch should give the power of the engine to the rear wheels smoothly. That is the gradual engagement. Third one is heat dissipation. So the engine's power, as the power given by the engine is rotatory motion, right, and it is given to the rear transmission. So in that case, a high amount of heat will be generated, right? That heat should be dissipated at the clutch itself so that the entire vehicle should not be under heat. Dynamic balancing. So the engine's power is transmitted to the transmission, so the vehicle will move according to the clutch's engagement. So it is under dynamic condition. So the dynamic condition of the vehicle should be balanced with the help of the clutch engagement or disengagement. Vibration damping. So when the vehicle is moving, right, it causes some vibrations. The vibrations are controlled by engaging the clutch smoothly and gently. Size of the clutch. The size of the clutch depends upon the torque transmitted by the engine, right? The turning moment or the engine's power, if it is more amount of transmission is required, that means the clutch is to maintain more transmitting capacity, or if the engine's power is less, it has to transmit less effort with less effort, right? Say for example, a passenger car, the load carrying capacity is less, so in that case, the clutch's transmitting capacity will be limited, whereas in case of four-wheelers like lorries, trucks and buses, the load coming on these vehicles is very heavy. The clutch should be very strong enough to transmit a high amount of energy to the transmission. That is the depending upon that is given by the size of the clutch. And free pedal play. Free pedal play means there is a clutch pedal fixed at the left side of the driver to engage and disengage. There are three pedals below the driver's position, like this. There are three pedals mounted, and the three pedals are connected by three linkages, three levers, right? So to remember the names of the three pedals, this is A, this is B, and this is C, right? This is accelerator, this is brake, and this is our clutch, right? So these three are the pedals. Of the three, clutch's movement should be very free. It should be operated very smoothly. That is called as clutch free pedal play. That means whenever the clutch is pressed, it should be completely disengaged. Whenever it is released, it should be completely engaged. The things we are going to discuss in the forthcoming session. And ease of operation, right? One thing is, the clutch is the main member that controls the entire automobile. Without the clutch, the automobile will not be controlled, right? So whenever there is any disturbance, first, or whenever the vehicle has to stop, the faulty drivers, what they will do is, they first operate the pedal, brake pedal, right? That's very wrong. Even for two-wheelers or three-wheelers, first member to be disengaged to stop the vehicle is the clutch. So what happens when the clutch is engaged means, the engine's power is disengaged. So no further load is acting on the transmission part. Then brake is applied. So what happens? The decelerating motion of the vehicle is controlled by brake. Otherwise, if reverse is applied. That means without disengaging the clutch, if you engage the brake, right, when the vehicle is going fast and the driver intends to stop, so without disengaging the clutch, if you apply the brake, what happens is the engine continues its running moment or continues its supply of power, right? But here we are stopping with the brake pedal. This causes the vehicle to roll or skid or tilt, right? Which causes an accident. So most of the accidents are caused because of the lack of the operation of the clutch. So it is 100% to be followed by each and every driver of either two-wheeler, three-wheeler or four-wheeler, that to stop the vehicle, first he has to decelerate the acceleration, then you have to apply the clutch pedal, then afterwards he has to apply the brake. So without applying the clutch disassembly, disengaging, he should not apply the brake. So this is the disassembled parts of the clutch, right? I will explain it with the schematic diagram in the future session. So the clutch consists of flywheel. The flywheel is the heavy block of mass which is connected to the engine. This flywheel is connected to the engine's crankshaft. This is the crankshaft of the engine. So to the crankshaft of the engine, the clutch is fixed, the flywheel is fixed. This is the flywheel. And flywheel is like this. It is a heavy block of mass, right? And having teeth around, right? It consists of evenly cut holes. These are evenly cut holes. And these holes are used to fix the nuts and bolts. These are called as pressure bolts. That we will discuss later, right? And after the flywheel is the clutch plate. This is the clutch plate. Right? The clutch plate is like this. Circular in section. It is having inside splines. These are called as inside splines or internal splines or inner splines. Gear teeth and splines. Gear teeth are the teeth provided on the outside surface of the shaft. When the teeth are cut, inside, these are called splines. Right? These are inside splines. And both sides of the clutch plate are fixed or the friction lining. Both front side and back side, it is fixed with friction lining like this. Here he has fixed the continuous friction lining, but most of the clutch plates are fitted with the brake parts of friction lining. And the friction lining is made of such materials which can withstand to very high heats and temperatures. that we are going to discuss in the next slide, right? And after the clutch plate, fixed is the pressure plate here. This is the pressure plate. Right, and it is the pressure plate is like this. It is having springs fixed to it. These are called pressure springs. Right, so after the pressure plate. Is the cover, clutch cover. Clutch cover is a dome-like structure. So it covers all the parts of the clutch. That is the flywheel, clutch plate, pressure plate. All these three are fixed by the clutch cover plate. Right. Right. Now coming to the types of clutches. The types of clutches we are having are cone clutch, single plate clutch, multi plate clutch, semi centrifugal clutch, centrifugal clutch. These are the types of the clutch. And now let us discuss about the types of the clutch assembly. As I told you, as I drawn you before, the flywheel. So the flywheel is connected to the engine's crankshaft. It is a heavy block of mass, as I told you earlier, right? It is heavy block of mass like this. It is connected to, this is the engine shaft. Right? It is a heavy block of mass, and the flywheel is made of cast iron, and the material is cast iron, and the process is casting. Flywheel is made of casting process by the material cast iron. Once again, the flywheel is made of cast iron material by the process of cast iron. Right? It is a heavy block of mass. It is having more mass. The main function of the flywheel is to take the power from the engine. Right, it restores some of the force which is given by the engine, some of the power given by the engine, and supplies the power uniformly to the other parts, right, continuously to the other parts. So that is the, that means it stores the energy. The main function of the flywheel is to store the energy. This is the function of the flywheel. And this flywheel is having holes like this, 6 evenly spreaded holes in it, which are used to hold the pressure bolts. So as I told you earlier, after the flywheel, fixed is the clutch plate having the clutch lining on both sides, and after the clutch plate, pressure plate, and then cover. So to fix the all the parts to the flywheel, so it is done by having the holes in the flywheel and the pressure bolts fix all these parts. Then the clutch plate, as I told you, and the clutch plate is made of steel disc. The clutch plate is made of steel disc. Disc means the plate is made of a thin sheet-like structure, right? And is riveted to the circumference of the steel disc. Friction material is fixed to the clutch plate on either side, as I shown you earlier, right? This is the clutch plate, right? Of course. This is the clutch plate. So it is provided with friction lining like this. on either side, front side and back, rear side also. Both the sides, the clutch plate is fixed with the friction lining, right? And the friction line is riveted, so that both sides it is riveted. Just like the case of the heel to the shoe. To the shoe, if it is the shoe, right? This is the heel. This part is riveted to this, right? And these are fixed for friction of the person to the road. Likewise, the clutch plate is having on both sides the friction lining fitted by means of rivets. Pressure plate, right? After the clutch plate is the pressure plate. So the pressure plate exerts pressure on the clutch plate onto the flywheel so that it moves along with the flywheel. Axial springs, these are springs used to apply the pressure plate onto the clutch plate. Clutch cover, as I told you, it is a closure which is closing all the flywheel, pressure plate, clutch plate and all the springs inside. Clutch release system, it is a operating mechanism used to have engage or disengage the power to the rear axle. Right. This is the operating principle of the clutch, or you can say the principle of operation of the clutch. Right, so we are having two shafts this is, let us say, shaft K, this is shaft L, right? And this is a rotating member A, this is another member attached to the shaft L, its name is B, right? Both are separately fixed. Now, let us say the shaft K is provided with a circular motion. Shaft K is connected to a circular motion, it is rotating, right? So, as shaft K is rotating, A also rotates. The pulley which is connected to the shaft K also rotates. But the shaft L which is free will not rotate, and B also will not rotate. At the next time, what I do is I apply pressure on the shaft L, right, and pulley B, of course both are same member, to press onto the body A. I will apply force on the shaft L towards A. So what happens, the position will be like this. This is shaft K, pulley A. Now it is coming onto B, is coming onto B, is coming in contact with A, right? So as a result, what happens is, as K is rotating, right, shaft L also rotate. Why? Because the shaft K's power is transmitted to shaft L from A to B, right? As here the two surfaces, A's surface and B's surface, are in contact with each other. Both are in contact with each other, right? So as both are in contact with each other, right, they form as single member, right? And due to frictional contact between A and B, they unite together and both shafts K and L rotate in the same direction, right? Here, what is happening is, here friction is developing. Now, due to the concept of friction, shaft B rotates with body A. So, A and B rotate in the same direction. This is the concept on which the clutch is operating. So, in the clutch, what is happening? We are here, the flywheel is rotating. With the engine's power, right? Like K and A. As the engine is rotating, this shaft, crankshaft is rotating, and with the crankshaft, flywheel is rotating. Right. Now, in between is the plate C, that is clutch plate. Right. And after the clutch plate is the pressure plate. This is the pressure plate. This is the pressure plate. Now, what we are doing here, when we want to have the engine's power, we have to draw it from the flywheel by pushing the pressure plate towards the flywheel, like this, right? So what happens, the force on the pressure plate moves the clutch plate also onto this, and when these three unites, that is flywheel, clutch plate, and pressure plate, flywheel, clutch plate, and pressure plate. When these three unite, so rotation of the flywheel and rotation of the pressure plate are in the same direction due to the concept of, again, the friction. Here I had shown you the two. Here there are three plates, right? You can assume one more plate here in between, right? And the three plates will rotate in the same direction, right? This is the principle of operation of the clutch, right? Once again, just I want to repeat whatever happened till now. Clutch is the member which is used to engage or disengage the engine's power to the transmission. Clutch consists of flywheel, clutch plate, pressure plate, and cover. Clutch consists of the parts, flywheel, clutch plate, pressure plate, clutch cover. These are the main parts of the clutch to all the types, but some parts will differ. These are the general common parts to all the clutch, right? So the principle of operation of the clutch is, clutch works on the principle of friction, right? Whenever two bodies are in contact with each other, right, they develop friction, and due to friction, the rotation of one shaft is transmitted to the other shaft due to the concept of friction, right? So here we are having flywheel, clutch plate, and pressure plate. All the three are united, and the rotation of the flywheel is connected to the pressure plate. That is the concept of clutch. Now, as I told you, the clutch plate is mounted with clutch lining on either side, right? As our shoe is having at the bottom heel, right? Which is in contact with the road, and which is to have the frictional contact of us with the road. Likewise, the clutch is having the friction lining on either side, called the clutch face material. Clutch face material, that is, to the clutch plate, this face and rear face are fitted with the material. What are the types of material? So it is used to quick dissipation of the heat. And what are the materials used for the clutch? Clutch lining or facing material. The general facing materials are leather, cork, fabric, asbestos, ferrule. These are the generally used friction materials or friction lining materials, we can say. Friction lining materials. These are called friction linings. Lining means a thin material adhered to the material. A thin material, a sheet-like material, which is adhered, means gummed to the main material. Here, as I told you, this is the clutch plate, right? To the clutch plate, on either side, we are having, of course, if it is continuous, we can fix the material like this. And the center is the, as I told you, like this. And this is the friction material, friction lining material. So what material we have to use, right? General materials which are used to clutch lining are asbestos and ferrule. These are, and fabric is not used. Why I mentioned is, as facing materials, very rarely used. Cork is used, leather is also used. Mostly asbestos and ferrule are used because they are good materials and cheaply available materials. Right. This is the working principle of clutch, as I told you in the previous slide. Right. Here we are having the two pulleys, pulley C and pulley D, right, fixed on two shafts A and B, right? And the shaft A is rotating, right? Shaft B is free. This is the clutch disengaged position. Here we can say the clutch disengaged position, right? Now, clutch engaged position. That means we want to take power from the clutch, from the flywheel. So when we throw the shaft B onto A axially, when we throw shaft B onto the shaft A axially, right? So there develops frictional contact between the two shafts, right? This is frictional contact. As a part, both will rotate in the same direction, right? This is the working principle of clutch. Right. Now, this is a 3D of a clutch assembly, as I told you, right? This is the flywheel. Right? This is the flywheel having a bulk mass, and this is the clutch disc, right? And this is the clutch cover. And this is the operating mechanism. This operating mechanism we'll discuss in the coming topic. That's all about the operation of the clutch, right? Let us summarize what is today's lecture. Clutch is the material which is used to engage or disengage the engine's power to the transmission, right? The main parts of the clutch are flywheel, clutch plate, pressure plate, and clutch cover, right? If we want to engage the engine's power, we have to take the engine's power from the flywheel, right? By throwing the clutch plate onto the flywheel, right? By throwing the clutch plate axially onto the flywheel, right? Here, the function of the flywheel is to take the power from the engine, restores some energy in it, and give back whenever the engine is not giving. So it is a it is used to store the energy when more energy is coming from the engine, and gives it when there is a break of power. So it stores energy and gives whenever it is required. That is the function of the flywheel. Flywheel is a bulk mass made of cast iron material by the process of casting. Clutch plate is the thin plate which is having fixed with clutch lining or clutch face lining, which are made of asbestos, rebestos, cork, ferrado, fabric, etc. These are the materials used for clutch lining. The clutch lining is fitted on both sides of the clutch plate and are riveted so that it will not ooze out from the clutch plate, because the clutch plate is under heavy turning speeds and more number of torque and high frictional contact it has to resist. So they are firmly fixed to the clutch plate. The facing materials are firmly fixed to the clutch plate. And then the principle of operation of the clutch is the friction. Friction is the principle of operation of the clutch. So that's all about the summary of today's topic.